Hello everyone. In continuation with our previous lecture, today we are going to understand about the drag created on a flat plate due to boundary layer. However, before proceeding for the main content, firstly we will clarify why we are studying this topic, what is the objective or why this topic is very important. So the primary question that we are going to address is why. Let me explain this with the help of an example. Consider that there is a wind farm in which wind energy is harnessed, it is captured so that it can be converted into electrical energy with the help of wind turbine and ultimately the blades of wind turbine. So in this case, the primary function of the wind turbine blades is to rotate properly in such a way that there is minimum loss of energy. Now it is very much natural that the objective of that blade designer will be to reduce the opposition created for its rotation because of the presence of the fluid called as air. Now this air is always in the surrounding of this wind turbine, and unlike the solar energy panels, these wind turbine blades, they function for 24 hours. There is no restriction for daytime or nighttime, and they always have to face the opposition of air when they are functioning. So if there is a designer who wants to improve the efficiency of the system, ultimately he will look for improved design and reduction of drag on that particular blade surface. And if he is able to understand the mathematical relationship between various parameters of the boundary layer, which is created because of interaction between air and the wind turbine blade, then ultimately he will be able to improve the design. And because of improvement in the design, efficiency of that system will increase, and because of that the cost of energy will reduce. More energy will be created in lesser time and with lesser investment, and ultimately the final cost of energy will reduce. Let us consider the second example. In case of aeroplane, the length of the aeroplane is very large, and that's why there is a significant passage available for air, atmospheric air, to come in contact with the plane surface. Also, the wings of the plane are very long, so we can conveniently say that there is very much scope for creation of boundary layer on the plane surface. So now, if there is a designer who understands the mathematical relationship about boundary layer and its various parameters, then he will be able to control those parameters so that the friction observed or the friction offered by the atmospheric air to the plane surface can be reduced. This will cause reduction in the fuel consumption of that plane, and thereby the profits of that aeroplane company will increase, and this benefit can also be transferred to the customers. So we can say that this mathematical understanding is very important. In this lecture, we are going to only understand the core concepts. The derivation for all these concepts will be covered in some other lecture, for which I will be providing the link in the description. So firstly, we'll understand. But just to give you a glimpse of what the situations that are under consideration, I have shown it with the help of figure. This is a simple flat plate to which the flow approaches with a velocity capital U from the left hand side. And because of their interaction, boundary layer is formed on the plate surface. Now, the solution obtained is called as through approach, it is obtained, and it is called as momentum integral approach, for which a control volume is considered as shown over here, the control volume ABCD. This is the left hand side of the figure. The right hand side is the zoomed in portion of that control volume A, B, C and D. As usual, in this derivation, an elemental strip will be considered which will be having thickness dy. It will be located at a distance y away from the surface. Small u is the local fluid layer velocity, and the DC indicates the outer edge of the boundary layer. Remember, beyond DC, the flow is mainstream flow or free stream flow. Now, the important quantity in this case is this local shear stress, or ultimately the basic shear stress, tau 0. According to Newton's law of viscosity, this shear stress will be given as tau 0 equal to mu into du by dy, but this velocity gradient du by dy needs to be obtained at the location y is equal to 0, which means right at the surface of the plate. So the drag force which is created because of this shear stress the drag force or shear force in that particular small distance delta x will be calculated as simply the product of shear stress and area on which this shear stress is acting. So it will be equal to tau 0 into delta x into b. B is width of the plate, which is perpendicular to the plane of the paper, just like our previous derivations. Now, according to our momentum principle, or we can say second law of motion, this force, drag force, must be equal to rate of change of momentum for that particular distance delta x. The final outcome that we get after the derivation, which will be discussed afterwards, we are right now concerned about the final outcome. It is given like this. The ratio of tau 0 to the quantity rho u square is equal to the differential with respect to x. Differentiation of this total quantity or total integral from 0 to delta of ratio of small u to capital U into the bracket 1 minus small u upon capital U with respect to dy. This equation is known as von Karman momentum integral equation, which is attributed to the scientist von Karman, who was student of Ludwig Prandtl, and he derived this equation in 1921 after application of boundary layer theory. In this equation, if we observe the quantity inside the bracket, the integral quantity is nothing but our momentum thickness theta. So in shorter form, the equation can also be written as tau 0 upon rho u square is equal to dabba theta by dabba x. Now, the parameter that we have studied earlier was the local drag force. Then the total drag force on the entire plate, if it is having a length L, it can be calculated as Fd is equal to integral of that elemental drag force on that small element or small portion, and it is equal to integral from 0 to L of its shear stress and area of the plate within the limits 0 to L. Remember, we have converted delta x into dx for the purpose of integration. Next parameter that we need to understand is the local drag coefficient. This drag coefficient is for that particular location on that flat surface or flat plate. It is defined as the ratio of that shear stress tau 0 to the quantity half rho u square. Mathematically, Cd star is equal to tau 0 upon half rho u square. Now notice, this quantity half rho u square includes a term of u square. So this is very similar to the kinetic energy expression, and this parameter is known as dynamic pressure. It is the pressure associated with a flowing fluid. Then the next parameter which is important is average drag coefficient. Now the local drag coefficient is for that one particular location on that flat surface, but most of the times we are interested in the value of drag coefficient for the overall surface. So that's why we need average drag coefficient. So it is defined as the ratio of total drag force Fd to the quantity half rho a u square. So mathematically, Cd equal to Fd upon half rho a u square. Next thing very important are the boundary conditions for the velocity profile. See this line. These boundary conditions must be satisfied by any velocity profile, whether it is a laminar boundary layer or it is a turbulent boundary layer. Now, why we have written something like this? That's why, firstly, we need to understand what exactly are the boundary conditions. Boundary conditions are mathematical statements which indicate or which tell you about the physical conditions which exist at the boundary. And that's why they are very important. The beauty of boundary conditions is that in such a small space of mathematics, they help you to understand so much about the physics which is happening at the boundary. Furthermore, they also help us in solving the integration to determine the constants of integration and arriving at the final solution when we perform the integration operation. So that's why they are very important. The first boundary condition is that at y equal to 0, small u is also equal to 0. At y is equal to 0, physically it means we are talking right about the plate surface. At that point, the local fluid velocity is equal to 0 because of no slip boundary condition. And notice this more important line. This line tells you that even if u is equal to 0, still the velocity gradient du by dy will have some definite value. Now, what is it physically? Even if u is equal to 0, means velocity of the lowest fluid layer is equal to 0. But the layer which is immediately next to it, on the top of it, will have at least some velocity. And that's why velocity gradient will be there. With the change in distance, there will be change in velocity. And that's why du by dy will not be equal to 0, even if u is equal to 0 when we are talking about the plate surface. This is the beauty of boundary conditions, that they tell us about the physics which is existing at the boundary. Next boundary condition is that at y is equal to delta, which means at the edge of the boundary layer, at the final surface of the boundary layer, the velocity of that fluid layer will be equal to free stream velocity, capital U. Then the third boundary condition is that at y is equal to delta, means again at the extreme of boundary layer, when which is acting as a boundary between free stream flow and the boundary layer, the velocity gradient will be zero. Now notice one thing. Here the velocity is equal to capital U, but still the velocity gradient is zero. Here velocity was zero, but still velocity gradient had some definite value. Why this is happening? Because this is the point at which the velocity is equal to free stream velocity, and beyond that there is no variation in free stream velocity possible, which means there is no du. There is no change in velocity when the distance changes, and that's why the velocity gradient will be equal to zero. This is the physical understanding that we have expressed in terms of boundary conditions in mathematical form. In our next lecture, we will apply all the understanding of all these parameters to solve the problem for the given velocity profile. That was the objective of this lecture, to introduce you to the various concepts. If you find this lecture useful, you can like it, subscribe the channel and press the bell icon. That's it for now. Thank you.